Hey, welcome to Talking in Stations. It is July 9th, and I am Matterall here with an old friend, Dirk McGurk.
Hey, what's going on?
Dirk. We also have Abby with us.
Hey, everybody.
It's Abby Roa from Talking in Stations. And Dominark, are you here yet? No. All right, so he'll be around in just a second. He's going to hang out with us as well. So, story we're following right now. It's breaking. It's brand new. That is Northern Coalition, which is a very popular and storied alliance, has kicked out one of its key U.S. time zone corporations called Sinners, or Original Sinners, and a second group by the name of... I will find it. And that is kind of a big deal. We'll find out why it's a big deal and why they got kicked in just a second.
It's Criterion.
Thank you. Criterion, yeah. All right, so let's get to that top story. And then afterwards, when we have a little bit of time, because these are developing facts right now, we don't have the full story. We don't have official statements or any of that. We'll try to get those during the show. We're reaching out to people and talking to them now. Again, Vince Draken, the leader of NCdot, is European time zone, so it's going to be hard to get his blessing to have press releases come out, that sort of thing. So we'll do what we can, but we'll have more information in the future, maybe this weekend. And if we have time after this, we're going to talk about the sizzling, what should we call it, summer of disengaged this year.
Disengaged? I'm super engaged.
There you are, Dominark.
Sorry, yes, yeah.
All right, top story. There's a group inside of the Northern Coalition called, it's a corporation called Original Sinners now. They are led, I think, by Brother Bob. And he has been thrown out for treason, and along with him, his corporation of fleet commanders, and also a corporation called Criterion. So
for treason?
Or treason. Like, is yes.
That was the actual word used as to why?
Actual word. Reddit, yeah. Yeah. So Reddit, and I've confirmed that this looks pretty accurate. I can't vouch 100% for it, but we're going to read it to you. Ready? All right, here we go. Vince Draken, I want to apologize in advance for the behavior of at Brother Bob, which includes treason and a total disregard for the rest of the alliance. They have also been in talks for the last few days with Criterion Corporation, and have made the decision to abandon this alliance and our family PamFam. As such, I have taken the decision to brand both Criterion and Original Sinners as traitors. So with this in mind, we will be switching our entire alliance focus to these two corporations. These two corporations and NSH, that is Nullsechnya Shoulpin, which is a group that's actually hanging out in Tribute in that area. I'll explain that relationship in a second. And here is more of the message. They have tried to facilitate this movement while I've been busy with the reopening of society across the UK and Europe, so much so I found out from everyone but those in these two corporations who frankly have weak leadership and follow a sociopath. As these two corporations have behaved in such an underhanded and coward-like fashion, as of 001 tonight, they will be treated no different to anyone else who is hostile to us and will all lose access to NC and PanFam structures. This is then likely to include anything owned by Tappy. To ensure we remain true to ourselves and our history, I will also be restricting their access to the drone region citadels until further notice. This perhaps might feel like a hardball reaction to a decision these corps made. However, they have done so during a period of downtime and during a period of real life rebuilding. I am more than happy to discuss this with those who want to discuss this individually. Please feel free to DM me. That is Vince Draken, the leader of Northern Coalition.
No, I DM'd him and I've not gotten a response yet. So,
okay. May not be high on his list.
No, I'm probably, who the hell is this guy?
Okay, so here's what's going on, if you want to know. And we'll do our best. I'm still getting messages in to kind of clarify, so I'm going to do my best here. I may get some things wrong, but...
Aren't we like 11 minutes past zero dark one?
Is that right? We are. Yeah. So 10 minutes ago, this happened. They've been locked out. Dirk, take it for a second. I'll be back. I'm just going to read some messages.
Take it. I just learned about it.
take it, run with it. That's your job.
Sociopath. Treason. Well, sociopath.
I'll take this time to point out that us in the Imperium, we are a healthy bunch of players who enjoy our time together, and none of us are betraying each other. Just want to point that out.
Okay. I got what looks to be correct, and I've kind of corroborated this with somebody else. So here is why. And I won't say who this is, but this person says, the plan was to join NSH and hit Amar, Losec, and Wrecking Crew. They took a vote Wednesday and weren't going to tell Vince until the weekend, believing they'd get 2 weeks to move and still have access to a Keepstar chain. And that is actually what tracks. I mean, that's kind of what I heard. They were in negotiations to do kind of a soft move to NSH to be able to hit, I assume, more targets or to be more active. The war zone seems to have cooled off quite a bit. I believe that actually one of the FCs, Pittsburgh, hasn't been very active lately. And so, you know, maybe they're just looking for more things to do. And they were going to move to NSH, but... they did not leave on good terms. One is, as written here by Vince Draken, these guys are being locked out, frozen out, because they didn't really give him good notice. He found out from everybody else, and it looks like it was kind of a secret. I thought they were trying to do something a little more out in the open. But I've heard additionally they were trying to poach corporations on their way out. And that's
always a no-no. No matter what group you're in, you just don't do that. And expect the people you're leaving to appreciate it, right? I mean, that's just, you got to expect this kind of reaction.
Right.
I mean, I assume that there is a good way to leave NCdot.
There is. You can leave NCdot. You literally can. I mean, I've seen it before. People make their peace. They leave. They get time to move all their stuff. This
in
kind
the
of,
middle of a war, though?
In the middle of a war. Right? Yeah. No, I think even in the middle of a war, you can. There's... Oh.
Blazing Bunnies out there, if you'd like to hear from the Bunny Meister.
Yeah, I love to have my stuff up. We're willing to bring him in if he's around. He is part of Original Sinners, one of the FCs there. I think you can leave NCdot even in the middle of a war situation. I don't think you get treated this way unless you have offended Vince in some way. And I have seen him offended, and I have seen him... And this is one of the things I like about Vince is... he's consistent. He will take action in the middle of a war. He'll take action. I've seen him in the middle of a war declare war on a different target because they made him mad, basically. And we had a two-front war. He's fearless in that way. And so it's not, he's not thinking necessarily in a strategic way, or is this going to look bad, or how will people play this out there in Imperium, for instance, who's probably going to celebrate this. He doesn't think in those terms on a priority level. He thinks of terms, he thinks in terms of like loyalty and service and, you know, kind of more of a soldier's view of things. So in that sense, these guys have offended him, and he's like, you're out. I don't care what time it is. I don't care what it looks like. You guys are out.
I wouldn't use the word probably either. I'm pretty sure we would definitely go to celebrate this.
Yeah. Oh, and interesting. That was, now these guys are the, Fleet Commander Corporation type thing. What's the equivalent of that in Imperium, for instance?
Fleet commanders.
No, I'm sorry. The, corporation. What's the corporation in, well, it would be
the FCs?
AMOC. Yeah, right. AMOC has the Fleet Commanders.
A lot of them, not all of them, but a
not
lot
all of them, yeah. But a lot of them, yeah. And then what was it before AMOC?
Dogfort.
What's that?
Dogfort.
Dogfort.
A whole bunch of them. Right. They left. They left to do other things. They left on good terms. Yeah. So it was a different kind of situation. But it still sucks when you lose a core person that has a lot of your FCs.
Yeah, it does hurt. So, there's Thomas Lear.
When you lose popular FCs, that makes it. You may have lose FCs who are busy, but when you lose like the big names or the ones who got that everyone knows, you know, the ones that people like to fly with, that hurts. And I think that Sinners do definitely have some of those people that known for sure, you know, Pittsburgh Blazing. I mean, even, you know, with Joey Redline, I can't think of the other ones. There's somebody else too, whatever. Big names, you know, whether they're good FCs or not, it's one thing. But when you're a popular person or a popular FC and you leave, that hurts your morale. It does.
Well, Blazing Bunny's in the audience. Hold on a second. Blazing Bunny's in the audience. If he wants to jump into Discord, we'll bring him on live since he's a fleet commander in Original Sinners. I assume he's going along to NSH with the other guys. So that invitation is open.
And they did link the Discord in Twitch chat there, Blazing. So.
Yeah. So, okay. So anyway, what's interesting about this corporation, why it may be a little special, is because it has a concentration of fleet commanders. And sometimes you'll get those groups that will have, normally when you join an alliance, I'm sorry, I'm going all over the place here, but if you join an alliance, you have to have something to offer. So if you're a corporation, you're coming to an alliance, you're like, it used to be, hey, I can field two dreads. And that was a big deal. That's no longer a big deal. But if you come in and you say, I've got two FCs, or I got an FC, or I'm an FC, and you know me, then that's a ticket in, basically, because they're going to draw on that resource as an alliance. So some corporations, though, will try to pick up more FCs, and that gives them a lot more stature inside of the alliance. If you're the one providing the structure for the military, that's a big deal. So in Northern Coalition, it was Doom for a long time that provided that leadership, and then it switched to Burn Eden. You had other smaller corporations. Burn Eden. I was thinking of Smell, which is burning napalm or something. Anyway, so that switched over time to Shiva, where Killa Bee joined, because the leader of Shiva is Nidaspar, who's one of the main FCs of this war for NCdot. And he's been there a long time. But on the US time zone side of things, you used to have Burn Eden, and that was run by Travis Muskrat. And so that was like, you know, if there was a fleet, he was the guy that was going to be leading it. He's the one that provided all the entertainment. And he had a certain style. And then you had Burn Eden leave. I think they went to PL at one point, or they bounced out. I forget where they went. But around that time, it switched over to Original Sinners. And then Original Sinners brought some FCs, was active, was doing stuff. You also had Thorn Syndicate in there at that time. This is a while ago. But over time, the FCs seem to have been, in the U.S. time zone, seem to have been from Original Sinners. And so that's why this is not a usual corporation, and that's why we're talking about it as news. This is a bigger deal than just a normal corporation. All right, let me try to catch up with some comments. Go ahead. What do you guys got?
It's not just a bunch of FCs. It is like predominantly the U.S. time zone FC core, right? So they're going to be very weak now in the U.S. time zone for the next couple of weeks.
Hard to say. I don't really know what they've got. I haven't been there in so long. I don't know what they've got, but they did have other. Of course, the VDD is as FCs in the Australian time zone. I don't know if Thorn's still there or even active. So I don't know what the U.S. time zone looks like for NCdot. But in this particular corporation, Sinners, you had Pittsburgh. You had didn't Joe move to Sinners?
Joey did.
Yeah.
Blazing Bunny.
Blazing Bunny's in there. And Brother Bob. And there might be another one.
Redline is there. I mean, whether you have FCs or not, I think he's really starting to
like Redline FC'd once when I was there, I think, you know. But he was up and coming. He just never came, never finished. So I don't know what happened.
Real life stuff going on, I believe. He had a house and stuff.
Hmm. Oh, there's Drayden. Drayden, can you come into Discord and we'll see what we have? Oh, dang. That was awesome. How's it going, Drayden? Oh, he jumped in before his hat was on.
Probably,
yeah. Yeah. So how do you work this mute? Before speak up. speak up when you get a chance. Let's...
I was leaders in chat. I think he was a great FC. I liked him a lot. He was fun.
Yeah. Who?
Thomas Lear. He was a dog for it.
Yeah. Thomas Lear. Yeah. Thomas Lear also, he went to, I should know this. He went to a different group that he started and stuff. And I think that recently ended.
Okay. There we go. Sorry. There was a Windows update. Every time that happens, my headset and my microphone get turned off for some reason.
All right, man. You're an NCdot. Are you still in Destructive Influence?
I am at the moment.
Okay. Tell me what's going on.
I mean, honestly, I didn't know any of this stuff was going on, but it just sounded, I mean, I kind of didn't, I mean, when this post came out, that's the first I heard of it, and just kind of going on what I was seeing people discuss it, it sounds like they were apparently trying to poach people, and then they left to NSH, and that's about as much as I know. I was saying, I don't know a whole lot on the drama, but it's kind of an uproar, and with Sinners gone, that's I don't know what you guys have talked about. You probably mentioned, but like, that's a huge. I mean, that's pretty much all of the U.S. time zone FCs for us. Not all, but
No, is it pretty much a lot of the U.S. time zone fleet too? Like the members, right? It's the biggest corp in the U.S. time zone, right?
I don't know about that. I think a lot of like line members come from elsewhere, but like you'll look at the fleet. The general fleet comms, and it'll be like all kinds of different other corps. And then you look at the command channel, and it's like 75% Sinners. So, and I guess Criterion is, okay, good. You have that up on the screen. I was like, I don't know how much of this is OPSEC, but it was in the general announcements of NC. So anyone that has a spy at NCdot has seen this. I'm sure this is posted on Reddit.
Yeah.
So this whole post is not OPSEC anymore. So yeah, I mean, Criterion, Sinners are gone. The Sinners Criterion being gone means that the meme channels are going to be very dry from this point on in NCdot. So we're losing our FCs and we're losing our memes. It's a that's a double whammy. Morale is going to tank.
That happened when Adversity was actually in NCdot at one point, and they just tore the place up, and they got yelled at a few times before Vince basically just kicked them out. We were happy to have the forums back after they left.
Oh, hey, Blazing's in chat. Nice. Blazing, I was trying to get hold of you. I wanted you to come on Open Comms too.
Yeah, well, I guess Open Comms will have like part two of this, right?
Well, Jesus, at this rate.
Yeah. I know. Right.
I was sitting there, I was like, I don't know if I ask Bob if he wants to come on. He probably wouldn't. I don't think he likes talk shows, but also, I was wondering, man, if I bring Bob on, maybe I get the boot. Vince would be like, wait, he went on where?
Yeah. Listen, let's recap what's going on for people who don't know. NCdot is obviously a known quantity, a known alliance inside of PanFam and the greater PAPI effort to fight the war. One of the groups that has been fighting a lot is the U.S. time zone part of NCdot. And most of the FCs that were in command were in one corporation called Original Sinners, and that group has been kicked from NCdot for treason. I'll read it right here. Treason and a total disregard for the rest of the alliance. Now, what does that mean? It means that Brother Bob was trying to move them to NSH, Nullsechnya Shoulpin, so that they could fight in Amari and Losec and take on maybe Wrecking Crew. And in doing so, trying to get, I don't know if it was public that he was trying to get them moved over and didn't inform Vince fast enough. That's ambiguous. But what is true is that he was trying to poach some corpse on the way out. And of course, this all comes from, I think this is not confirmed by Sinners, but this is by somebody else familiar, said that the war effort was slowing down a little bit and kind of stale, at least the kind of combat was stale. So this may be an effort to kind of keep some interest for their guys and moving to LowSec and just doing some different things. Why they would need to move out of NCDOT to do that, I don't know. Maybe because they were instructed to stay there on the front and couldn't leave. I don't know what the particulars are there. But they were going to move to NSH. They were going to took a corporation with them, Criterion, and they were trying to poach other corporations. It got back to Vince, and Vince basically is like a very decisive leader, said you're out and you're locked out. You're locked out of everything that we have. You're locked out of everything Pandemic Legion has, everything Tappy has, which is Test and Legacy. What's interesting here, he didn't mention Fraternity, who's kind of allied with NSH, I think. And so there might be an interesting, interesting dynamic going on there.
Interesting, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Be interesting to see where Fraternity is on this. Let's actually try to get word from Naros. Let's see what's going on there.
From how I read it, it sounds like Fraternity and the whole Pappy family is kind of aligned behind his decision because of them being locked out of all of the Pappy structures.
Yeah. What do you guys think?
Well, I'd like to take this opportunity to invite Sinners to come home to Bastion, where they used to be. You guys are welcome to join us.
I was
going to
say, Vince was saying that within 24 hours, they're going to be locking Sinners and Criterion out of pretty much everything, and Test is going to probably do the same. So there may be a lot of fire sales going on.
Including drones.
Drones too. It's not just down in Delve. They're going to be locking out of everywhere. So if you're looking for cheap shit, then you have a way to get it out. Or if you're in NCDOT and you're looking for cheap shit, look at the markets, man. There's going to probably be a bunch of cheap stuff.
Or Drayden, you're going to get some DMs saying, hey, man, can you smuggle this out for me?
Yeah. I'd have to find a way to, like, fuck. My jump freighter is so immobile now.
It's full of too many things.
That's not the answer you're supposed to give on air anyways. You're supposed to be like, I would never do that.
I would never do that.
Come on, Drayden. You're going to get yourself kicked.
He basically puts out the invite. Hey, guys, if you need something out, go ahead and let me know. I'll help you get it out.
Well, you're friends with a lot of these guys, right? I mean, you're friends with, you flew with these guys and you're friends with them.
Bob and Blazing Bunny were my two favorite FCs by far. Pittsburgh was really good. Pittsburgh is like super effective, but when you went on a Bob or a Blazing fleet, it was just, everything was chill. Fun. Everything was like just nice, you know. Like even when people fucked up, it's like, the fuck you doing? You're an idiot. Anyway, all right, let's dab everyone. Let's just jump through the gate then. Fuck it. They want to jump. Let's go. Everyone jump. It was just so laid back compared to a lot of the super strict, like screaming FC fleets. So you'd see like other fleets. Like I see a Vince fleet. I mean, again, I'm probably shoot myself in the foot by saying this, but I see a Vince fleet. I'm like, I see a Bob fleet. It's like, oh, hell yeah, that'll be fun.
Oh, you're a totally different player than I am. I am totally the reverse. I want like all business, you know. I don't want an entertainer, you know, juggling while the plane is being flown. I want a pilot who basically says the weather's good, we're gonna land, you'll be fine.
Yeah, but Bob and Blazing were good FCs too. So what if he was a trick pilot? Like he was great at flying the plane while juggling. Like, wouldn't you want that?
You want no fun in your game, is what you're saying.
Yeah, I don't like fun in my Eve. I like business. That's it. Serious business. Yeah.
Oh, I like fun. Now, to a point, I mean, there gets to be a point where it's just beyond ridiculous. I don't want, you know, those kind of fleets, but
interesting.
It's just generally fun.
Got it. Interestingly, Pittsburgh, Moloch, I wonder if that's true. And do we know if Pittsburgh's going along with Original Sinners? Are you staying behind? Has anybody stayed behind?
I haven't heard anything on it.
I have heard at least one Original Sinner stay behind, saying he didn't want to go. He wanted to stay with NCDOT. I don't know.
I'm sure that there'll be people that want to stay. And there's like that thing, like, you know, that's saying, hey, I'm sure that feel free to DM me is basically, hey, if you're caught up in this, but you don't want to go, we can, you know, get you into another corp that's sticking around. But I mean, I would have said Bob and Pittsburgh were pretty damn good friends. I would,
it'd be hard for them.
I'd be hard pressed to believe that Pittsburgh would just leave and stay with NCDOT if everyone else that he's been in a corp with was heading out.
So Original Sinners moving to Nullsechnya Shoulpin. They're actually in the tribute area, I believe. And I think they were They were actually looking for things to do. They got into a big fight against Wrecking Crew, where they made a huge difference and took out like 7 Titans from Wrecking Crew. That was a while ago.
Blazing's in the green room, so why don't you give him a drag?
Okay, so let's find out what's going on from Blazing Bunny here in just a second. Blazing Bunny, welcome to Talking In Stations. What's going on?
I haven't seen some of y'all in a long time.
Yeah, I was going to say, it gets more and more.
Yes, I mean.
It sounds ominously familiar, but I have no idea where from, so I'm just going to try to ignore it.
Okay, so tell us if you know anything, like what your experience was. How did you find out this news, if you knew?
So I'm absolutely going to open with this very canned line I typed up so I wouldn't fuck it up. Hang on. Oh, sorry. So at this time, I'm not going to talk about anything specific about the Alliance, current plans, or future plans. Any questions you have that are very broad, other than membership or what we're planning on doing or what's going on, I will be happy to try to answer. But other than that, we're not going to go into a lot of depth at this time.
Can I just have your emotional reaction that's personal to you?
I've been playing this game for 10 years. Weirder things have happened.
So this is not that big a deal.
That's not at all what I said. I said,
recharacterize it.
So I've been playing this game for a long time, right? EVE Online is a big, scary place. Things happen.
Okay.
That's it.
What's your emotional state?
I want to know how you feel. Few people get a chance to go through this situation. So like channel us through like what it's like.
I mean, there's probably a bunch of confusion amongst members, but anybody who's been a director in a corporation, if something happens, if you fall apart at the seams, then bad shit happens. So we handle it 1 hour at a time, 1 day at a time, 1 week at a time. We move on. Mm-hmm. It's a video game, right, guys? So like, come on.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's more of social media plus a video game. That's why we're here talking about it. But so NSH, tell us about NSH. Do you know them? Do you like them? What do you think of them?
Me and Anur and some of the other NSH guys have been playing Rainbow Six Siege together for a very, very long time, except for up to the point we tried to make a pro team, and then one of our members raged out, and then it became unfun. I like them. I think they're a good group. The blue crab is better than the red one. That's all I got.
This
is probably going to be a very boring interview for you because I'm not going to talk about what we're doing or what the plan is.
I know. Listen, I don't want to put you in a bad spot. It's public information right now. We're ahead of the information, right? It's behind us. Things aren't necessarily confirmed. I appreciate that. And I'm not pushing you to say anything you don't want to say. Nor am I daring you, nor am I trying to trick you or anything like that. But I do feel like you're at the center of the universe right now because, I mean...
To think that people, it's Friday afternoon in U.S. time zone. I really like to think that people have better things to do with their times than worry about what Original Sinners is doing. But
yeah,
well, I can understand the fascination since we have such little to talk about this game now.
Yeah, no, this is front and center in the media at the moment.
Well, but this is a crack.
The whole weekend.
This is a crack, right? I mean, let's be fair. We have a huge war. It's been going on for a year. We haven't really seen anything. This, I would say, important, right? But you have an FC team from U.S. time zone from a group that's doing a lot of work. NCdot was doing a lot of the work. After M2, guys did a lot of the work and basically brought the war back to life. And that crew has been kicked for treason from NCdot, which is not something that happens all the time. I think it's a big deal.
I guess that's
I would
really
agree.
The question.
It is a big deal.
Really, the question then is, you know, what does this mean for, you know, any broader scope of the war, you know, coming from that direction?
I'm excited as a member of Bastion. I think this is an opportunity for us.
keep trying to win them back.
Get our people back.
I did just come from talking to a couple of people, and then because a couple of people were watching, and we heard the Bastion shout out, I got a lot of laughs.
Yeah,
because like a lot of the older heads, right? Because way back in the day, that was Sinners was in Bastion. Like a lot of our current member base, the guys that play a bunch, that was way before our time. Like I joined while Sinners was in NC, and so everybody who joined after me obviously would be in the same boat.
Yeah. Well,
I think it's a lot of the current state of the war that you got bored with the current targets and started looking elsewhere for like fun content.
I wouldn't really say one way or the other. I have fun, right? Because it's a video game. I come home after working 40 hours a week and I unalive some space pixels and then I get to do it again. It's not really boredom. It's not really any kind of animosity. It's, you know, like I said, it's a video game.
Yeah. Blazing Bunny joining us from Original Sinners. He is a fleet commander. You've heard his voice a few times on some of the recordings during the war in Delve. And he's been a longtime player. He's with us now telling us some of the stuff that he can say. But it is early on as we're finding out that Vince Draken, the leader of Northern Coalition, has kicked a couple corporations, one a critical corporation, Original Sinners, to the U.S. time zone. So that has a lot of fleet commanders in it. And they are moving over to Nullsechnya Shoulpin. I guess there's some friendships you were saying behind the scenes, like you guys were playing different games together.
I mean, it wasn't a mass thing. Like I've played some games.
Well, let's not confirm NSH until I get a chance to offer our
a counter offer.
Our counter offer. Yeah. Come on now.
From the bastard.
We offer a lot.
Good luck getting Pittsburgh back into the Imperium. I just don't see it happening.
Oh, I don't. Oh, what could we offer them? Nothing. So, yeah.
Well, I don't know.
Casper might come back. That'd be it.
But NSH is in the north in tribute, that area. One of the reasons we heard is that Original Sinners was looking for some Amarian Losec campaign to go up against a wrecking crew. So
you, interesting. That was the one part I was turning this on whenever you said, I noticed you read something that wasn't off this post in Reddit. You mind rereading that line for me?
That wasn't on this post. That was from an unnamed source.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was curious. I mean, you've already read it once. What's the harm of reading it again?
Oh, I have no problem reading it again. Let's see. The plan was to join NSH and hit Amar Losec plus Wrecking Crew. Sinners took a vote on Wednesday, and weren't going to tell Vince until the weekend. And believing that 2 weeks was enough time to use the Keepstar railroad track, as I call it, but to get to where you were going. And they left that's as much as I'll read about that, but can you characterize that as true or untrue?
At this time, no, I cannot. I will not say one way or the other.
One way or the other.
Like I said, in my opening statement, I will not comment on current plans, future plans, or anything about the Alliance.
But you wanted to hear it again, and that's why I
did. Yes, well, only because I only caught the back half of it. I wanted to make sure I was.
Yeah, I got it.
Understanding.
But Bunny, can you speak to the treason aspect of this? I mean, do you see it as that? Do you guys feel as though you were trying to get out the right way, or the way you thought you had to get out, and therefore, how does that relate to the treason comment?
I would say under normal circumstances, if we were to be having this conversation, maybe tomorrow or not immediately after, because as anybody who runs a corporation or runs an alliance can obviously sympathize. Like right now, everything's a little bit tenuous. You know, people are confused with, you know, in good reason, and mm-hmm. I'm not going to assume anything like that. I'm just going to wait. And we're waiting to hear back from people, waiting to talk to people, you know, all that jazz. We still have court members who, you know, we talked to previously and haven't got a chance to get on yet. Probably about to be blindsided by a Reddit post of all things. So,
one's already out, but
of course, I'm sure you'll understand if I don't really elaborate too
much. Yeah. And I'm sure that you're doing this out of respect for your leadership. You don't want to be off the message that they may want to craft, you know, like it's a stressful time when the news is just breaking, and it's important news. You can tell because again, there's already a Reddit thread about it. There'll probably be a second one. There'll probably be some public declarations coming over the weekend. But what confirmed, Original Sinners is no longer with Northern Coalition.
As of, I don't even know what Eve time it is right now. Oh, yeah, double lot 42,
ago, I think.
Basically,
double lot 42 as of 42 minutes ago.
Yeah,
we're operating. Original Sinners is operating under the assumption that that is the case. But like I said, we're still, you know, it's still very, very early. We're not making any assumptions. We're not doing anything rash. Everybody's taking a breath. I'm drinking a White Claw. Like,
oh my God, we were just talking about how that nobody should be drinking White Claw. Like, have you guys heard of White Claw? We'll talk about it.
I
think most people have heard of it.
Well, we're.
Okay. Have you guys heard of White Claw?
Yeah,
I've never heard of it.
We were like, we're quitting Tito's. We're doing White Claws for open comms
now. Oh, no. Anyway,
you're doing that alone, buddy.
I'm brand new to this modern day wine cooler thing that's out there. But
yeah, it's not even a wine.
This is not even new.
It's a modern age Zima with some flavor.
Whatever.
Zima is actually better than White.
You know what?
And Zima's awful. So I mean, there's that.
Sorry, we're off track. As a rule, don't make fun of what people ingest. That's not nice. So I apologize. Not going to go in that direction. But
oh no, I do that all the time. What are you talking about?
Okay, so can you? Let me ask you one question. I don't know if you'll answer this one, but can you at least characterize, like, is there any communication going on anywhere with anyone?
Naturally, yes. We're reaching out to people we know, people that, you know, in the Alliance, trying to, you know, we're trying, everybody's got questions. So it's very rapid development, all that shit.
So. Okay. So it's ongoing.
I would assume, I mean, isn't something like this always going to be ongoing? You can't really, like, if you, a corp just doesn't get kicked and everything's, you know, happy, clap right. your hands and be done with it.
Right. There's old relationships there, too. I mean, you guys have been in NCdot for a while now, right? Let's take a look at that. List of corporations, and I wonder if you're even off the list yet. Let's take a look. Here's Thorn Syndicate, Original Sinners. You're still in NCdot. I have news for you. You're still in NCdot as of this moment. But
I'm logged in right now.
Yeah. but this group here will be leaving. You were there since 2017.
Yep.
Pretty much around this time. I mean, a little short.
And then before that, I was in Militaris. I was in UDED for a little while.
Oh, I didn't know that. Oh.
Yep.
All right. Oh, wait a minute. No, I almost got you confused with Pirate Bob or whatever his name was. Thorn Syndicate. Can you tell me if they... I love Thorn Syndicate because, Dirk, we have a mutual friend in Thorn Syndicate. Do you know who it is? Yes. Appears in podcasts every once in a while.
Lucian?
Lucian James. In Thorn Syndicate. FC'd actually, but he FC's under Keith, I believe.
Yeah.
Keith Rowe. Yeah. Keith Rowe. Are they still
when
there?
When I joined NCdot and I was on several fleets, and it took me quite a while to realize that that was Lucian James. I was like, I've heard this guy.
Heard that voice before.
Somewhere before, because I flew with Lucian James when we were in CO2.
Hmm. Did you say, I've heard that sleazy voice before? I love that guy. He is original. Yeah. So I wonder, Keith Drow, is he still FCing?
Funny? He's still active, yes.
Okay, good. And so how many FCs are in NCdot that weren't part of Original Sinners? Just to get an idea of like what's left after you guys create this void.
As much as your chat roasted me because I haven't had Discord updated, which I did, by the way, for all y'all doubters. I have not been the utmost of activity the last, probably we'll call it 3 weeks.
Uh-huh.
So I couldn't tell you really who is and who is not active right now.
Was Ryzak Sinners or is he someone else?
No, Ryzak is Northerners.
Northerners. Hmm.
Yeah.
So, can you tell us who's in Sinners? We can look it up, but if you could just tell us who the like FCs were, because there's a few big names there.
That I can say because I'll just regurgitate what I almost call them Del Taxi for some stupid reason. What Brisk posted. So it's myself, Bob, Pittsburgh, 29 something something, Red Line, if you want to count them, and then Joey Zom.
All right, so it's Joey and Pitts that are we're doing a lot of the work inside of Delve, I think. And you,
I would say they did. I would say they did a ton of work. Yes, yeah. I did. So most of the work that I, most of what I did was back in the fountain, the basically from the 4th of July last year to I went on vacation before M2, so that would have been up to that point.
The beginning of the war up to entering Delve, I guess.
So I was the one, I was the one of the FCs for the Boson trap.
Yeah.
I was one of the FCs for the 49U.
Yep. Those are big fights. Stuff. Big, big fights.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I look back on that stuff with a lot of fondness. Somebody was posting somewhere that we were like, I don't know. There's a lot you get. I think most of the wars in EVE is you sit back and think of the two or three good fights that you really, really enjoyed to be part of. And YZ9 is always going to sit, you know, forefront for me. Not very often after 10 years or 11 years of doing this, and after 8 years of being a fleet commander in some capacity, you still get the shakes. And, you know, telling your fleet mates to jump to a Sino that you just saw a bunch of Titans warped within 30 kilometers of, that'll do it.
Yeah, that probably gets your heart racing.
But there's a lot of, I mean, everything even past that, like the GOTG war, all of it, it was all a good time.
Right. And so who was doing a lot of the reconstruction work that needed to happen after M2, after the big, I don't know what you would call it, loss of
debacle.
M2?
Debacle.
I was going to say debacle.
I don't know if you really call it reconstruction. I don't know what I would call it, to be honest. I was not.
We need to get that.
It wasn't really me. I tried to jump. So Bob in Pittsburgh decided, you know, to really power on after that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Through some innovative tactics and all that jazz.
You guys stole a keep star. You guys destroyed a keep star.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
Yeah.
I remember Big Bill DeBoss dropping his Hall Phoenix on the freighter that we used to scoop it.
Did he kill it or did the freighter get away?
No, we counter dropped him with like, I think he dropped three dreads. I don't know. He'll have to tell you. And then we counter dropped with 11 or 12.
It just, you made it out with his lunch basket.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah. Green keep starting though is a wild, wild thing to do, especially in a contested zone.
Right. There was some stuff going on. It was pretty, pretty fun. So original Sinners, it looks like this is not what Blazing Bunny is saying, but from other information, looks like they'll be going to hang out with Nullsechnya. And if they're going to follow through with what we suspect are their plans, they may be fighting Wrecking Crew, maybe, or at least looking for some combat in low-sec Amari in space in that area. Maybe that bleeds over into Providence. Who knows? We don't know. We also know that discussions are ongoing, whether they're to find a way to get settled. We don't know. What we do know that's true, and this is confirmed, is this post is actually authentic, and this is Vince Draken saying that they are original Sinners, that is, and this other corporation called Criterion, cut off. Now, how bad does that affect you, Bunny? Because you were saying you weren't that active lately.
All my stuff is staged where the Alliance was staged, so...
You're shit out of luck, so probably.
Yeah, I don't know about shit about out of luck. I'm a crafty guy.
Hint, hint, Drayden.
Yeah.
Oh my God, Drayden's going to be watched.
I mean, I could just take, you know, another couple weeks, everybody calms down, and then I disappear into the sunset. Like, it's not the end of the world. Like, it's a video game, right? Because I could just leave my Titans and shit here and then just go kill somebody else. You know what I mean? I'm not like, yeah, it sucks to have my assets stuck, but it's not the end of the game.
No, don't worry. Horde don't do.
Didn't Drayden say anyway. He'd get him out for you?
Yeah, but I can't fly Titans, so I don't know. Actually, maybe I could technically get in a super, but I just can't fly them because I don't have the skills to actually use the stuff you need on them. But
all right.
Well... not. It would move supers for traitors and shit like that. You know.
There you go. Cover your
head. I gotta cover my bases.
I think it's okay if it's treason. It's high treason is the one you really want to look out for.
Oh,
that does get you a lot more trouble. Yeah.
Yeah.
Dirk, do you have to go?
Yes.
Yeah, bro. It's like we're gonna go get ready.
I gotta get some stuff set.
Well, all so right, 10 minutes. 10 minutes to open comms. We're gonna lose some people here, but we'll take you there right after that to continue this conversation. You can find out more, maybe more information.
We'll probably talk about this, you know, paragraph. We'll
talk about the non-intelligible aspects of all this.
So. The jokes and the fun will be.
Okay, hang on. We got tons of white claws there too.
Bring a white claw.
Yeah, bring a white claw because there's no rules on the open comms.
Don't get to look at the screen and see what I got my wife.
I'm down to my last raspberry one, and then I have a whole bunch of pineapple ones after that, and I'm not looking forward to that because they're
that
like
just sounds horrible. Yeah,
yeah, they're real gross.
This is some new information that's just coming through that you may want to hear, Blazing Bunny, since it may impact your situation. I appreciate the above ping is perhaps, I believe this is coming from Vince Draken, and this is a new post. I appreciate the above ping is perhaps drastic to some, but there are many variables here. So as such, Monday night, 2000 Eve time, let's discuss it and clear the air on the situation. To confirm, despite my above post, I've not issued a full court-martial. Fuck these guys so much, so I want to trap them here. So he's not wanting to trap you there. If they get caught, they die. However, we ain't about to start camping T5Z or NSI. See you Monday.
That's called a rope-a-dope. Get you guys to let your guard down. Bam, he's going to get you. Come to Bastion.
I don't think
roads lead to Bastion.
Full circle, baby. Full circle.
Yeah,
I think your stuff one
like you're you know you're driving in the car, right, and you hit something, you get knocked out, and you wake up in the back of the cart in Skyrim.
Yeah, I think I think instead of go ahead.
I don't know. That was I don't know where I was.
So I don't want to. I think what this is, the second message that came out, softens this a little bit, basically saying they're not so bad that we want to cut their heads off with a guillotine, which has happened in the past.
It sounds like there's an opening to possibly come back in the future.
I don't know. I think
that sounds like we probably can't take them, so we're not going to force the issue.
Yeah, I think it's more like we're going to work out an exit for them, so they're not completely ruined, basically. So, Bunny, you may actually be able to get stuff out if you're trapped without any help from Drayden.
Sure, I DM him so we can stand down his legion of Titan capable alts.
Yeah.
Well, help with Drayden is always
that's
just so
a
much
meme,
fun,
by the way. It? Drayden's not.
Did no he take off?
No one's.
For a modest fee, I'll smuggle anything.
Blazing Bunny and Drayden.
Not a trader, but $20 is $20.
Anyway, that's a Denny's Grand say, Denny's Grand will, Slam. Go ahead.
I will say that it will, if more information or it becomes more practical to talk about this in the future, then I'll be more than happy to do so. But at this point in time, I realize I came on here and stonewalled, but it was pretty frustrating to sit on comms and listen to y'all guests. So.
Well, I mean, if you're coming here to clear us up and to get us accurate, I appreciate that. That's why we bring you on. That's why we bring people on.
Yeah. But
I feel like that didn't happen just now, though.
But yeah, but if you come on to say, no. I can't say anything, it's not really helping.
I hope I answered something. I don't know.
You did. You gave some color to the situation, which is fine. A human aspect, which we like, too, since we're all players, right?
On that note, I have to go. So
okay, man. Thanks. Take care.
Yeah, I gotta hop on as well. I gotta 5 minutes.
Minutes. Go stand up your show. We'll go there next.
I'm really good at fucking multi-boxing, so I can be stupid on bullshit.
That's right. You gotta go too. You should
I don't have to.
You should go get ready if you want. Everybody,
all the time.
Everybody jumping into the green room so they can get ready for open comms, which follows this. We'll send you there right after this, so stick around for them. Probably get more information on what's going on. But let's recap. Vince Draken sends out a message earlier today, about an hour and a half ago, let's say. I want to apologize in advance for the behavior of Brother Bob, which includes treason and a total disregard for the rest of the Alliance. They have also been in talks for the last few days with Criterion, another corporation in NCDOT, and have made a decision to abandon this alliance and our PanFam family. As such, I have taken the decision to brand both Criterion and Original Sinners as traitors, so they, with this in mind, will be switching our entire alliance focus to those corporations and NSH. That is a huge announcement there, if he's turning the focus to NSH, which is possible. That is something that Vince would do. They have tried to facilitate this movement while I've been busy with the reopening of society across the UK and Europe. So much so, I found out from everyone but those in these two corporations who frankly have weak leadership and follow a sociopath. I assume he's talking about Brother Bob. As these two corporations have behaved in such an underhanded and coward-like fashion as of 001, which was about 56 minutes ago, tonight, they will be treated no different to anyone else who is hostile to us and will lose all access to NC and PanFam structures. This is then likely to include anything owned by Tappy, who is an ally. To ensure we remain true to ourselves and our history, I will also be restricting their access to drone region citadels until further notice. This perhaps might feel like a hardball reaction to a decision that these corps have made. However, they have done so during a period of downtime and during a period of real-life rebuild. I am more than happy to discuss this with those who want to discuss it individually. Please feel free to DM me directly. That is a strong statement from the leader of NCDOT, Ben Strachan. We assume this second message follows, where he clarifies a bit. He says, I appreciate the above ping is perhaps drastic to some, but there are many variables here. So as such, Monday night at 20 Eve time, let's discuss it and clear the air on the situation. To confirm, despite my above post, I've not issued a full court martial. Let me read that again. I have not issued the full court martial. Fuck these guys so much that I want to trap them here. If they get caught, they die. However, we ain't about to start camping T5Z or NSI. See you Monday.
So I'd just like to point out, if you'd like to see a drama-free group who's handling this war with utmost respect and, you know, dignity, the Imperium is just dominating that aspect of this war.
Yes.
And it's only one jump you need to move your stuff.
just reiterate it to Brother Bob, the offer is on the table. All right,
they were there at one point.
You guys have a good night. I'll be back over the other side.
Take care. See you later.
Best of luck.
All right, so a little more ASMR from Matterall here. Thank you, Rain, for that joke. So basically, Original Sinners out of NCDOT, along with this other corporation, Criterion. They were trying to poach a few corporations on their way out. It looked like they were going to NSH. That's what we understand. They wanted to fight Namari and Low Sec and also try to mix it up with Wrecking Crew. In doing so, they fumbled on their way out, obviously, because Vince is upset about this. And he said he found out from everyone except them that they didn't approach him and say that this is what they were going to do. And they did it at a time when Vince was pretty much away or society's rebuilding itself in the UK. So this is not something that he takes lightly. This is also not something that he wouldn't... Like, Vince is not afraid to cut anybody off. I've seen him come down on lead FCs before and just basically demonstrate nobody's above acting a certain way. Now, I don't know, but it seems to me that there's more to the story here than just this incident of wanting to leave NSH. I think there must be more color to this, some more history. They've opened... Original Sinners has been in NCDOT since 2017. And so there must have been differences growing for a while now. All right. Well, what do you think of all that, Abby?
Yeah, it's mad. I mean, it's interesting. There's, I get it. I mean, when you're playing a game and the game you're playing stops becoming fun, you want to do something for your members, and it seems like the corporation was just trying to do something good for their members. Unfortunately, they, I don't know, seems like maybe they fumbled the ball with it. Maybe there's something that's been going on for months, but it's definitely a big blow to Pappy. I mean, make no mistake about it. This is NCdot's kind of like prime US time zone FCs. The Imperium's definitely going to be able to capitalize on this over the next couple of weeks, and they should. I mean,
let's actually explore this just a little bit longer from the Imperium's point of view. They have stalemated the advance of Pappy at 1DQ's constellation. And this is the first real indication, besides some bombing fleets that were successful and battles going back and forth, that were roughly even. Maybe they favored Imperium a little bit, but we looked at the stats and it looked like it was mostly back and forth. And there wasn't really any further advancement of Pappy into 1DQ. The latest on that whole area was that these... I think they're piggyback jump, I don't know what they call them, the conduit jumps actually from Black Ops may actually open up the backfield of the very, very secure 1DQ constellation and maybe open things up. Maybe the lowering player base will actually create opportunities for the front lines to shift in some way that's significant. But other than that kind of stuff that we were hoping to look for, this is a real... this is a real thing. You have an FC group. I don't know how active they were at this time. They were very active after M2, which was February. So it's been a long time. But I don't know how active they are or were lately. We hadn't actually heard from NCdot in the US time zone in weeks. We've heard Headliner doing stuff and other groups, Test and Horde. We haven't really heard of NCdot. I'm not sure how active they were. So we don't actually know how big a blow it is in these circumstances. Come later, if the war gets churning again and we see bigger fights, you're going to miss those FCs if you haven't replaced them. So I think the Imperium can look at this as a benefit to them. I don't know how big a benefit. Again, we don't know how active they were, but this is definitely going to be celebrated as cracks forming, I assume. Right? Like,
absolutely. Absolutely. I mean, this is going to be, this is going to be celebrated as the Imperium is one alliance, one corporation. They stick together. They are strong. Look at the cracks forming in We Pappy or Paspi, whatever they call them. Right? Right. And it's true, but I don't think this is that big a deal, but I do think the Imperium could capitalize on this and make it into a bigger deal.
How so?
I mean, it's a hairline fracture. Right. All it takes is, like, in this war, in this stalemate, this kind of trench war, you need to work on little cracks, little hairline fractures, open them up a little bit.
But I disagree here, because you're not cracking any more of NCdot out unless there's a lot of anger towards Vince. And that second message is kind of telling. Maybe he needs to do some damage control, right? Maybe not everybody is behind it. Morally, and that could be a problem. That could be a problem. We don't know.
This could be a big moral blow where corporations who were a bit on the fence about leaving or not are like, maybe it is time to go. Maybe I don't want to be treated like this. Maybe I will start moving my stuff out.
I think the fact that he wants to clear the air tells you something about confusion, right? They're like, hey, is this a big... And it is a big deal. You don't do this sort of thing and it's not some kind of a big deal, right? Like, nobody's going to yawn about this. Unless you're just being facetious. But the idea that you're going to have a meeting to kind of get things straight, maybe make some announcements about replacements, this sort of stuff, means that there's a real effort to get this organized and to put a box around it. Does this weaken NC's position? Maybe in the US time zone, it would. I think a lot of the FCs in the European time zone were not related to this group at all, or any of the groups that left. There's only two that I know of, but I don't think anybody else has left. We'll have to see in the coming days if more corporations peel off. I was in NCdot, so I'm going to predict I suspect not. And also, Original Sinners is only there for 3 years. In NCdot, you have some old corporations, a lot of old and established, and relationships have been there a long time. So I just don't see NCdot. I almost see this as a fracture of part of the rock, right? But the rock itself is still completely whole. And do you
Yeah, you got to chip off the edge or something.
Yeah.
But the,
do you think
the
though,
core is still solid?
Will this affect Pappy in general? Is there any sign of instability beyond NCdot that can, you know, infect the rest of the group? Is this a moral blow to them?
Yeah, I think this is definitely a moral blow. I think it could be turned into like a tactical victory or a strategic thing on the battlefield if the Imperium want to really push hard to try and work on the moral side and then try and combine that with, like, you know, again, lower participation numbers. They could really start doing a little bit of damage here, slowing down Pappy even further. I mean, you know, you need to be strong across all time zones. If you're dropping Asbels every other week, you want to make sure you got that good, strong core. But definitely for Pappy, I mean, this sucks. This is whatever side you are. You know, in an active war zone, to have one group of your alliance or have one group of your corporation walk away and say, nah, I'm done, I'm doing something else, that hurts everyone's morale. I don't care how much you say it does or it doesn't.
It doesn't.
When...
I'm going to contradict you again. We have to contrast, right? And you're right. You're
absolutely.
Yeah.
My
feeling is these guys might have been appreciated for the fleets they did. As you can see, Drayden liked their fleets, and he's an NCdot. He's staying with NCdot, which tells you something. But I don't know how much that extends outside, right? Like, how much were these particular fleet commanders like liked by Horde that this is impacting to them in any way, or even Pandemic Legion? And I'm not sure that's the case, but I haven't been there in
a while.
But I don't think it extends far. I think this is something of an isolated case with important FCs, but I think they were more important before. And this might have been, we've seen this before when a group that's really good, really talented, like the Culture, right? If you higher than Everest, was a great corporation. Was it Skywalker? Oh, God, I forgot his first name. Harvey Skywalker and Rancor Bile. Great, great guys, good FCs, really a cool crew to be with. But when they owned Fountain, right? This is before they sold it to the Imperium as the Culture. They were dying and they were like, I need to get these guys some fun. So we got to get rid of this region Fountain and go and do something else. So they put it up for sale and sold it to Imperium. And that created a whole shift in power that they weren't even aware of or didn't care. But they went off to Losec to revitalize their own crew, which was their priority. They ended up in Pandemic Legion, and they actually took over Providence. Those are the guys that took over Providence before Test came and ruined it and took over Providence from them. And then all the stations changed to Fortizars, and Test collected that huge amount of wealth. And so Harvey and the boys from Peak, that's called Higher Than Everest, they were out of luck. So anyway... it's interesting. Small, effective FC groups need to stay alive. Sometimes they need to devolve or go into a different situation in order to keep their guys active. And that's a very internal decision. And the ramifications of it that happen outside of it can be big or small. It depends on the situation that they're leaving. And so I think that's what's happening here. But unlike Peak, I think this may actually not be as big a deal, only because the war is at a stalemate and it's summertime, and I don't think these FCs in the U.S. time zone were active enough to create a ripple effect through Pappy. Pappy's very big. Yeah.
That's very true. That is very good points. I also think this could... I think any corporation leaving an alliance, particularly during a time of war, will create some sort of moral hit and some sort of tactical and strategic possibilities, even if it's 10 dudes, if they're active and they're very active, because this appears to be, you know, a large chunk of the US time zone NCdot FCs. But more importantly, like, if they go off to Losec and they start having mad fun and they're out there blowing stuff up every other week and having the kind of fights that some people start missing, because, you know, as you said, the war's come to a stalemate. There's lots of small grinding. There's lots of the same fights. There's none of these big fights that appear to be happening since the M2 debacle. Maybe I just get bored of this and I want to go shoot something else, and maybe seeing someone have some fun might draw me there.
Yeah.
Or maybe Pappy just, you know, tighten the reins and they become stronger and they cut the fat and they get leaner and stronger with it. And it could absolutely bring them together and help them push.
I'll tell you what, it makes me want to join NCdot again. It makes me want to get back in there because I kind of didn't see eye to eye with original Sinners. So I was like, I'm not going to fleet up. And eventually I just atrophied out and decided to do high sec for a while. And now, I don't know, kind of interested. I always liked Vince. I like the way he runs things. I like the European guys in there. Love Lady Scarlet. She's awesome. And I have some old friends there. So I'm kind of thinking like, they probably won't let me back in. But if they would, I would be considering it. And yeah, we'll end on this. Abby, you remind me of one of my Eve friends, Harvey Skywalker, who is an awesome player. Not only was he good, but he was hilarious. And you kind of remind me of him with your style of talking and stuff. All right.
I'll take that as a compliment. Thank you.
It is a compliment. Both you guys. All right, everybody, thank you very much for hanging out with us. We had this basically like news break moment. We took the whole hour to talk about the departure of Original Sinners from Northern Coalition. Original Sinners being the FC group for U.S. time zone coming out of NCdot. They were going over to NSH. They may be fighting in low-sec Mars space, maybe fighting Wrecking Crew. They have been kicked out for treason because their plans to move were found out by Vince Draken, who didn't take kindly to being left in the dark. So he has excommunicated them and shut off their access to stations as of an hour ago, all over NCdot's territory and Pandemic Legion's territory. And we assume Tests and Legacy Spaces territory as well. That really locks them out. So they were also locked out, or will be locked out, of the drone regions as well. That was the announcement that came out an hour ago. Right after that, maybe about 15 minutes ago, we got a second announcement saying, we're going to have a meeting on Monday. We're going to clear this up. Again, from Vince Draken, that is confirmed. And he says, although that was a harsh announcement coming out, he's not sure that he wants to completely guillotine these guys. So there may be some wiggle room there for Original Sinners. Maybe they get some of their assets out of some of these areas. So maybe they're not crippled. We'll see how that works out. They're going to need that extra bit of help. NCdot, Pappy, we'll all need that extra bit of help if they want to beat the Imperium coming this summer and into the fall. So that's where we'll leave it. Abby, thank you very much. Thanks to all the guys that were here before. And thank you guys for coming and watching as we talked about NCdot kicking out Original Sinners. We will see you next time on Talking in Stations. Stay tuned for open comms.
Fly dangerous.